Hello learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. I am Manisha Gaur and now we will discuss about maintenance of wooden surfaces. Maintenance of wooden surfaces can be done in several manners. First, you can vacuum clean it or you can clean it by using a lint-free cloth to remove the dust. You can use a damp cloth also, which can be dipped in mineral spirit, naphtha or paint thinner. Wax can be removed from the wooden surface by using paint thinner. Similarly, oil can be removed by using paint thinner as well. Now you need to wipe the clean surface with wet cloth to remove the residue that can be present in the wooden surfaces. Now let's discuss how we can clean different woods in different manner. First, let us see how we can clean oiled wood. Oiled wood can be used in several manners that it has a very shiny gloss. So there are different methods for cleaning it as well. So never wax an oil finish. Remove white spots by rubbing toothpaste, cloth or a mild abrasive like ash, salt, baking soda, pumice stone, likewise. And oil like olive oil, petroleum jelly or cooking oil. These can be used while cleaning the oiled wood. Now let's see how we can maintain and clean the painted wood. Now painted wood can be very easily being cleaned by just dusting it with a lint-free cloth every day. On a regular basis it can be done. And if not clean as such, then we can use the vacuum cleaner to clean the wooden surface, and we can have that attachment of brush into it so that we can vacuum clean it with a brusher. We can wipe with a sponge to remove the finger marks. We can use a hard paste also, or a hard paste of a wax once a year to fill the cracks and to give it a smooth and uniform finish. Now let's see how we can maintain polish wood. Now polished wood needs to be finished with spirit polish, varnish, lacquer, thermoplastic finish, like it can be melanine, polyurethane or wax. We can also use commercial polish to clean wood surfaces, and this method is very quick method. So the material get spick and span in a very short span of time. We can wear cotton gloves while using wax to avoid fingerprints or the dabbing onto the surface of the wood. Now let us see how we can clean specialty wood. Specialty wood can be very easily cleaned by vacuum cleaning it on the regular basis by having the brush attachment to it. We can occasionally rinse to restore the moisture of the fibers. We can wet the cane seed so that it becomes very tight. Now let's see what are the care and maintenance of the cane. So cane is a very lightweight and it is used in chair, table, basket, partition, boundary wall and wall cladding. Now let us see how we can maintain cane surfaces. A cane surface can be maintained by dusting it daily with a brush. So it doesn't require much maintenance as such. You can just maintain it as such by just dusting it with a brush on a regular basis. You can wash it with warm salt water and dry it completely in open air. You can also coat it with clear varnish to prevent staining. It can be polished also by using liquid wax polish. But it's very important to know what not to do while maintaining the cane furniture at home. You are never supposed to soak it cane under the water. It completely spoiled it. Therefore, avoid soaking cane in water completely. Now let us see after going through the maintenance procedure for wooden surfaces and how we can maintain the wooden surfaces, we will now switch to maintenance surfaces. Like how we can maintain surfaces at our home. There are two basic maintenance surfaces that we are going to discuss in this lesson today. First is maintenance of water supply plumbing services, and the second is maintenance of electrical power supply and fittings. Let's look at each of them one by one. Now let us see maintenance of water supply and plumbing services. So first we have water treatment plant like RO, that is reverse osmosis process, like we have at commercial as well as at residential places also, where the water supply is hard water mainly. So we have water softener plants, we have motor greasing, leaky taps, cisterns that require maintenance and the repairment. We have clearing clogged pipes and drains. So let's look at each one of them one by one. So this is how the maintenance of water and plumbing services are being done by a professional plumber at our home place also. These are the some of the images. So now let's see, first we will discuss about the water supply. How we get water supply at our home? It's by overhead tank or by running water or by having, you know, boring water supply and summer sewer tank, etc. So now we are going to discuss how we can clean and maintain overhead tank. So you need to regularly clean it. You need to drain out the water once in 2 weeks, like we do at overhead tanks or overhead, you know, we have small storage tanks at our home also. So we need to follow the same procedure for cleaning them as well. We need to clean and refill with fresh and clean water. So that could be done periodically, like once in 2 weeks or maybe after 1 month definitely. Now let's see how we can maintain a drainage facility at our premises. We need to use acidic powder to avoid choking. We need to maintain the water pressure so that the water uniform flow of water can be maintained. We need to make the flow of hot tap water after each use. A handful of baking soda in the kitchen drain once a week, followed by very hot tap water, that will clear all the clogged material that are there, that get left over into the sieve and the very small pores of the drain pipe. So it will all get drained off by using this method of mixing baking soda in the kitchen drain once a week, followed by very hot tap water. So now let us discuss what are the plumbing faults, what are the commonly occurring plumbing faults that needs to be taken care at the premises. Now we need to frequently repair the taps, because after a while, due to its aging or otherwise, taps becomes unfunctional. So we need to remove it or we need to replace it or repair it as and when it is being required. So how can you repair the taps? So let's discuss. First you need to change the washer of the leaking taps. First stop the water supply by turning the main switch off, you know, turning off all the water supply and then changing the washer of the leaking tap. You need to further unscrew the hand wheel, remove the hanger and unscrew the hand gear accessing the stem. Replace the old washer with the new one and place the stem back and put the entire thing back into its original place so that it can become functional again. Switch on the main supply and let the water flow. Now, how can you repair the flushing cisterns? You need to clean the tank periodically to maintain its smooth functioning. You need to change the ball in case of corrosion and puncture. So now let's discuss how can we maintain electrical power supply and fittings at our premises. So electrical power supply and fittings can be reached out to us in several forms. First is how you need to maintain the transformers, LT panels, generators, generator sets or DG set as we called it at our premises. Lighting panels and fixtures, like you need to do the replacement of faulty lamps, LED bulbs, lights and CFLs. Fans, switches, sockets, MCBs, main circuit board, fuse and electrical accessories. These are the electrical power supply equipments or the fittings that are there at our premises and we need to regularly maintain and repair them. So let's see the care instruction, and these are the precautionary instruction as well, because electricity is highly life-changing thing, and you need to be very careful while dealing and using the electricity at any premises. So these are the certain care instructions that should be followed by each and every one of us. Always wear rubber slippers. Always use dry hands completely while you are dealing with wires and electrical equipment. Always keep a wooden plank or woolen blanket handy. Always disconnect the main supply or at least unplug the appliance. Now let's discuss about electric fuse. An electric fuse is made up of a thin metallic wire, normally of a tin, lead and zinc alloy. Sometimes due to a short circuit or a faulty appliance, fuse wire melts and the fuse blows so that the entire equipment gets disconnected from the main supply. This is the main function of the fuse wire. So how you need to repair the fuse wire in case the faulty circuit has flown and the main circuit has been cut off due to the fuse electric fuse wire melting. So you need to switch off the main supply, identify the faulty appliance and remove it, remove the fuse, cut out and remove the melted wire and clean it. Replace with a new wire by passing it through the hole. Replace the corrected fuse cutout, close the box and switch on the main supply. Now let's see the use and purpose of 3-pin plug. So you must have seen at your home where you know there is an high electricity flow is required, like you have iron, you have heater at your home. So these equipments which require high electric flow, they must be provided with a 3-pin plug. So the 3-pin plug are mostly of two sizes, either 5 or 15 amperes. Due to high current, they sometimes melt, thus expose raw wires which can lead to an electric shock. So there are like 3-pin plugs, they have like 3 circuit current flowing through them. One is the positive, that is flows into the red color wire, negative, that is flow in a yellow or some other color wire, or we have the neutral or earthing, which is very important, that is always a green color wire. So the earth wire is thicker than other wires. Now let us discuss the steps that are there which we need to follow when we have to change a 3-pin plug. First, unscrew the main screw. Place in the middle of plug. Unscrew the small screws on each of the 3 wires and pull them out. Replace with a new plug. Put positive in one screw band and negative in the other parallel to it. Tighten the screws. Make sure the two do not touch each other. Put the neutral wire in the lower screw band and tightens the screw. Put the cover and tightens the main screw. Now let us discuss fans. So for fans, as we all know, we must have done it at our home very frequently, or otherwise also we know the fan can be clean and they should be cleaned regularly by dusting, following with the damp cloth maybe, or some sort of a brush that we can also use for cleaning regularly the fans. Now we also need to check the motor and regulators for noise free operation in specified speed, so that we can done periodically, maybe after a gap of 2 months or 3 months, or once we find that some sort of difficulty or some sort of unusual noise is coming. Now let us discuss bulbs, tube lights and switches. How we can clean and maintain the bulbs, tube light and switches at our home to have the uniform performance. We can regularly dust them with dry and wet cloth. We can clean the switches with acetone or methylated spirit or choline for stains. We can check the light for their brightness and age. Switches need to be checked for their intact fitting and smooth operation. So these are the basic guidelines that we can follow to keep it uniformly maintained and functioning. So now let us see how we can maintain inverters at our premises. Dust inverters with a damp cloth regularly. Change the battery water regularly. Check the battery monthly, or in case you find that some sort of difficulty has arisen. Maintain a ledger for inverter function, like keeping a record when you have changed the battery water, when last you have changed the battery, so that keeping the record of each and everything will give you a sense of the performance of the equipment. So now let's see how we can maintain air conditioning at our premises. We need to regularly clean the filters. We need to regularly maintain condensers and copper foils. We need to regularly clean and maintain the chiller tanks as well. So learners, in this lesson we have understood about how to maintain and clean the wooden surfaces. There are like many wooden surfaces, oil, polish, specialty wood and many other, how we need to maintain them to have them working perfectly fine for a longer period of time. And then we look into the maintenance operation of plumbing system as well as the electrical equipment, how you can maintain the faulty taps, leaky taps, faulty cistern, and how you can maintain a uniform water supply at your home, how you can clear off the clogged drainage at your premises, and also how you can maintain the electrical equipment at your premises. Like you have discussed and understood about fuse wire, you have understood about 3-pin plug, what is the function of 3-pin plug, how you can maintain a fan at your premises, air conditioning at your premises, inverter at your premises, how you can maintain and clean them on a regular basis. I hope that now you have understood it all, and I hope that you are able to maintain your premises well at your home place, and wherever you go, you are able to check and maintain the premises well. Thank you.